Okay, everyone on this guy. And now that guy. Interesting. And what's this? I don't know what that effect was. Is that his March of the Kamoa? I guess so. Oh yeah, daggers, maces, breastplates. Assorted copper. For mercenaries, they sure don't have a lot of money. I guess they spent it all on drugs. Ooh, Nereid's Grimoire. Robes and padded armor. Now I know there's a way to put spells, I think to change around spells or something like that. I'm gonna have to mess with that. Okay, we're busy trying to see what's in here. Svef. They're protecting it. Svef can be traced back to provisioners in the Valian Republics, where the markets for the plant in question enjoy rapidly rising demand. Most commonly chewed or inhaled, Svef is infamous for the near catatonic state in which it often places its adherents. Those who use it claim that the drug gives them a sense of urgency and meaning, lost when the effects fade. More colorful accounts claim that the drug allows one to look within themselves and witness the sight of their own soul. Yeah, we'll take it. I can't believe Pernisc is letting us use this place. He never let us do that before. This your first time here? You'll be back, I'm telling you. Well, these guys sure won't.
Sure.
A couple of crude beds have been improvised from an assortment of tattered blankets and pillows. Dribbles of some dark liquid stain the fabric. Hmm. I'll see it again. I will. I have to. Ah, don't hurt me. What's going on in here with this? It's still glowing over here. No? Okay. The Book of Valian Love Sonnets has a dedication on the first page to my beloved Kenra. He's fallen rather low. Someone has peeled the labels from these bottles. They're stuffed with a dark, gunky pulp that gives off a pungent odor. Trapped? Trapped? Nope, okay.
I'll have it in no time.
Do we not have 3 lockpicks?
I'll have it in no time. Hey.
Is that Eater actually doing it?
All right, then.
Because it doesn't sound like his voice.
What?
Oh, I barely heard you. Is he... He's all the way back there. What the hell are you doing? Thanks, Durance. A scepter. And 52 silver finnings. That's it for all this lock thing.
Fine.
Yeah.
The pots are crusted shut with some unidentifiable gunk. What is this, wheat? Grain. Didn't want to tell us what it is. Silly grain. Now either Pernisc is dead, and that's his hand. She was holding a hand, but we didn't find a hand on her when we searched her. Should I be sneaking? Maybe I should be sneaking.
Keeping an eye out.
Oh, there's more mercenaries up here. Yeah. See if we can pepper him with a few arrows before he makes his way over to us. Oh boy. Okay. Amplified thrust off of Aedyran or whatever his name is. Magic missile on that guy. We'll be able to see him shortly. Knock down. There you go. That shows up now. Just attack him. Alright, so... Soul Shock. Can I do Fireball? Can I just, like... go like that? Cool. Didn't hurt our guys, did it? No, but all of a sudden we have a lot less people to attack. How many are there? One or two? Awesome. A fine greatsword, a fine flail, fine spear, fine stiletto, a fine small shield. Let's hold on to that. Oh, a key. Rusty bronze key. A small bronze key that was found in Pernisc's house. I wonder if we can go to the other house. Or it might be just something in this house. Else is using a shield, so I'm gonna just put this in the stash. We can still see the chunks here. They're gone now. It appears as though someone rummaged through this uneven row of books in a hurry.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
176 copper pans. These jars are chipped and cracked as if knocked to the ground and set back in place. Someone was looking for a book. And they were trying to be quick about it. Oh, that's what the key goes to. Aedyran Dialects. The sun does not set on the Aedyran language. Those of us who commune with this proud language or some derivation of it populate every corner of Eora. Most of us who speak this wonderful tongue know it as Aedyran, but scholars and those obsessed with correctness often qualify it as modern or contemporary Aedyran. This is to contrast the language you and I speak together with Eld Aedyran, the old elven language that was spoken in the Aedyran Empire back before the pioneer settlers of the Deerwood built their longships. If Eld Aedyran could be considered the mother of the living Aedyran, the language of Hillspeak could be seen as Aedyran's cousin. Hillspeak is fading from common use, but many of the elves, especially the older one, in the Aedyran heartland still use this dialect. Whether you know it or not, you can read these words. You can understand Hillspeak. It is almost identical to Aedyran, but includes a large vocabulary of archaic words that have fallen out of use in today's Aedyran. When you hear bards sing old Aedyran poems, there are often lines of chorus that sound like melodic nonsense inserted to complete rhymes. These are usually instances of words that are lost from our common language but still used in Hillspeak. So it's kind of like Old English or something, with a thee and thou and all that. While Hillspeak is familiar to the speakers of the so-called modern Aedyran, the same cannot be said of our language's predecessor. Eld Aedyran is a dead language spoken by academics but not used in any major community. Eld Aedyran words are often familiar to Aedyran readers, but the words use orthography that has since been abandoned. Unfamiliar accent marks abound. For example, Eld Aedyran contains some diphthongs that have no place in the modern Aedyran, as well as a few tricky consonant clusters. Ea creates Ea, an Ea sound that sounds like the colloquial salutation Heya. Ao sounds like Ao. This word is still used in the modern word Aora. A is pronounced Ae, such as in Wraith. No, Wraith is just pronounced Wraith. Oo and Oo both create long Oo sounds as in loop. E sounds like an E sounds as in B. Guy? Sounds like the consonant... No, U. Oh, it's that's a ya? G, J is ya? Sounds like a consonant Y as in U. SC sounds like sh, so you pronounce scop like shop. I'm never going to remember how to pronounce this stuff. I hope I don't have to read in this language. CG sounds like the dig end of a word like hedge. It is not uncommon for given names of Aedyrans, Deerwoodens, and Red Sarans to come from Eld Aedyran. For example, Alduin is pronounced Alduin because of the long vowel sound on the Y. Dernish is pronounced Dernish since the final SC cluster sounds like a sh sound. Gyester is pronounced Yester on account of the GJ consonant cluster. Sledge is pronounced like sledge. Thirsh is pronounced Thirsh. Ushgrim and is Ushgrim and not Usgrim. Ingmar is pronounced Ingmar, leading with the vowel sound. Okay, I'm done with this. Back to the story, back to the game. Yeah, I'm still sneaking. Potion of Major Regeneration. Give it the canna. More stuff to read. 103 Silver Louche and Magranic Benediction. Neither let thy trials burden thee, for in thy suffering thou shalt be transformed. The ever-living flame will burn away thine impurities. Purification shall be thine. The fire of thy God shall be the vessel. Your endurance must love this one. Seek not to clash, seek not for conflict. These will find all in turn. The fires of strife will consume thee, but fear not the battle, fear not the war. Embrace the strife, but turn thyself from the struggle. Keep thyself strong against the trials that shall overtake thee. Fire, flame, the searing heat of Magran's fury, all these await the unfaithful, the weak, those that help not themselves. Take heart in thine own strength, take comfort in thine own power, take control of thine own path. Let the fire guide you, let the fire transform you, let the fire purify you, let the fire consume you. That's right, I gave it the office. Is there something over here to look at? If I get closer? No. Seems like a strange little alcove here. Hey, 15 golden dukes. Okay, I'm gonna open this door.
I'll take a look.
I have not saved for a long time. Of course, this is a two-part episode. Since I realized back when we came, as we fought those mercenaries, we were running way over, so... 67. Pernisc, I presume? Oh. Someone has gathered sheets and towels into a makeshift bed. The rumpled fabric is stiff with blood and unwashed sweat. One side of the overturned vase is splashed with crimson. A man lies bound and bloodied on the floor before you. His face is a tapestry of bruises, and blood is spattered across several corners of the room. The man cringes and sobs as you approach. Gods, please, please no more. I can't take any more. I'm not here to hurt you. The man pauses, gazing up at you. You're not? Oh, praise Barath. You're not one of his men, are you? He glances nervously behind you. He shakes his head. Please, I don't know who you are, but my name is Pernisc. This is my house. You have to help me. Then who was that downstairs? An imposter. Some wizard named Nirid. He came into my house, tied me up in here, tortured me. And now he and his men are eating my food, breaking my things, selling Svef inside my own house. He blinks. This would be a lot easier if you were if you weren't trying to hide something. Pernisc looks away, unable to meet your gaze. I may have hung on to a tiny portion of my supplier's share, but I needed that money. What exactly happened? He sent over the wizard Nirid, the man downstairs. Pernisc shudders. To make up the lost copper, I guess, and to hurt me while he was at it. It feels like it's been days. He's already been taken care of. Pernisc stares at you. I can't believe this nightmare is finally over. He grins weakly, then seems to remember something. You've no idea what you've done for me, but... He looks up at you and away again. I need to find my love, Kenra. Only, after whatever Nirid put her through, I'm afraid she won't give me a chance to explain. But she might listen to you. Please, she must be somewhere in Copper Lane. It's the only home she's known. Yeah, we know exactly where she is. And please don't tell her about the Svef, about what I do. I could make it worth your while. A discount, maybe? Might doesn't always make right. Kenra sent me here in the first place. She did? Pernisc smiles brightly. That woman helped save my life without even realizing it. Please bring her home and tell her everything is back to normal. I'll go talk to her, not lying about that. Not saying what we're going to say to her, though. I can't thank you enough, truly. How I've missed my poor Kainra. You're right. Thank you for all your help. If you find Kainra, I promise I'll make it worth your while. Let's go talk to her. That was a good little battle in the middle of all this. There's been a lot of reading and talking, and it's good to have a little battle in the middle for a change of pace. Well, they've all left, and the mercenaries have either decayed or have been dragged away.
Well, whatever happens, at least we're out of that mud hole, Gilded Vale. I grew up in Gilded Vale. Quaint! That's what I meant to call it. No. You had it right.
Ha ha ha. Awkward moment, but it's actually okay, alright. She's at the Goose and Fox, so before we actually... I'm gonna look around outside. Before I go into Admeth's den, I'm gonna go finish that, but let's see what's out here. It's your kitty. Hello, kitty. Marketplace. Ooh, 150 experience just for finding this place. Don't fall into the canal. Narmer. The merchant smiles brightly. Well met, traveler. Are you interested in purchasing any rations for your journeys? Just out of curiosity. No. No, I'm not going to ask him that. I want to buy a dagger for a little kid. Show me your wares. Dragon eggs. While full-grown dragons can grow to titanic proportions, their eggs start out just larger than a human torso. They make for very filling meals if one is willing to brave the risk of raiding a nest. Well, we wouldn't have to brave... We wouldn't have to brave it here. Dragon meat. Dragon meat is considered a rare and exotic treat for the fairly obvious reason that it is not very easy to obtain. Many tales and rites of passage have formed up around the idea of consuming the raw flesh of these beasts. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Plus 3 resolve, plus 3 might. Expensive, though. Should we buy a couple of them just to have? Oh, I'm still... Done. I wanted to move this... What do I do? Put it in here? I want to split this thing up. Kainra's ring. Where's the meat? I don't know where it went, guys. Am I looking right at it? Are these different kinds of lockpicks? See that? They disappear when you do that. Why can't he hold them? Is it just too many? Oh, this is really annoying. I can't stack more than five, they're just lockpicks. You know how tiny lockpicks are? Consumables. Dragon meat, here it is. Where'd it go? You're just driving me insane, this game. Where is it now? Would I do drop them or something? Oh no, I put them into quick items. Okay, what I would like to do... How do I split it up? One. Okay. Well, that's really annoying. Have it for our fighter types. Laura. The young woman stands by a cart, watching the crowd with large bright eyes that focus on you as you approach. Take your time, traveler. If you're looking for enchanted scrolls or garb, you've come to the right place. We have stuff. Potion of major recovery. Potion of major endurance. Oh. Maelstrom. Stamped with the embossed sigil of a storm cloud, this scroll describes a spell by which a caster create a damaging torrent of flame, ice, lightning, and corrosion. Nice. Missile barrage. This dusty scroll describes a spell by which the caster can send a sweeping array of fiery projectiles after a single target. Scroll of Valor. This scroll grants the caster knowledge of a spell, which in turn improves the accuracy of every ally within range of the spell's influence. Even green recruits can be made to target with precision the weaknesses of one's enemies. Paralysis. Stop a group of enemies in their tracks, allowing the caster to finish them off unhindered. Revival. Though no scroll can reach beyond the shroud and return one's fallen comrades to life, this spell can prevent their passing, for it restores to the incapacitated the vigor required to set them back upon their feet. I should buy a few of these. Ashwood cameo figurine. Whoa, 15,000 copper. This intricate piece has been created from one small piece of ashwood. A raised relief has been carved across the front, depicting an eerie, beautiful figure standing beneath a large and twisting tree. Her face is turned slightly to regard the viewer, as if having just noticed their presence. It summons a Dilemgen. Potion of Power. Incorporating the restorative of volatile powers of necromancy, tinged bones, this foul-smelling but potent elixir is undeniable worth in a fight, for it can give even the most hapless of fighters the effectiveness of an aged veteran. Iron skin. Artificers generally refrain from listing the ingredients involved in the creation of these potions, citing decorum. In any event, they give the imbiber's skin a tough and durable quality, making them less susceptible to damage. Plus 8 damage reduction until damaged. So I guess they keep missing you until they hit you and then it's gone. Telda's ring? Oh. only used by wizard. An elven wizard of Aedir, Telda was forever frustrated by the limits of her own considerable powers. After spending almost 2 centuries mastering most of the spells known to Kith, she found that her greatest challenge lay not with her repertoire, but with her inability to make more frequent use of her magic. She spent the last century of her life studying a means to amplify her abilities. When at last she developed the spell she needed, she had it built into this ring so the prudent wizard need not cast a spell to make use of it. So 2 extra 2nd level spell uses and 1 4th level spell use. Wow. Seal of Faith. Usable by priest. Okay, more uses for that. The thick iron band is dented and scratched and appears to have seen much use. It is studded with 11 small beads, one for each of the gods. It was created by an Aedyran priest to remind him of his devotion, particularly in the heat of battle. It is said that, feeling his fingers rub against the beads, he would say a quick prayer to each of the gods who blessed him in return. This stuff all looks pretty awesome, but we do have other potions we haven't taken yet, so I'm going to pass on this stuff for now. Let's see if, she wants this stuff. He might want more. He might actually... He's probably not going to want any of this stuff. Because he sells fruits and vegetables and stuff. It's candy. Okay. Thanks for watching, everyone. Tune back when next time when I explore more. Mm-hmm. Of the marketplace. We've got more here. I guess that's an Amawa, and I don't know what she's doing. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.